You want to have a look at this one? It's come down from a ward saying that it's not reading correctly. It's a pretty vague description, but what we're going to do now is just put a essentially a patient simulator on it, which is just one of these. So simulate a patient ECG signal. But this will give us a good idea of actually what's actually happening with the system, if there's anything wrong with it. But if there is, this is actually probably the best way to find out. You should start seeing it pop up on the screen now. There we go. There is a definite line between what's a medical device and what's not a medical device. At the end of the day, we have to make a clear understanding that anything that's connected to a patient is a medical device. A medical device has to meet a certain criteria, has to be tested at a certain interval under any ISO standard, so it can't be treated as just your standard computer. As far as what we're concerned, this machine is fine to go back, but we'll keep it with us for another little bit, and then we'll send it probably back this afternoon. So screen didn't display correct flow. I'm Stephen Locano. I'm the Senior Biomedical Engineer at Sir Charles Gairdner Hospital in the Department of Medical Technology and Physics. Initially, I'd done a trade in electronic servicing in domestic equipment. From there, having an electronics background, I started in here and pretty much on the job training. Then I actually supplemented my education. I went and done an undergraduate degree in health and computer science. I've done anatomy and physiology training. Within the course they provide to nurses, you know, because it really is good to understand what you're trying to measure. Okay, not that it's just a squiggle on the screen that looks like something and alarms when it doesn't meet a certain parameter. Why are you trying to measure? Do you understand what the integration is of the equipment to the patient? So the electronics background, how the signal processing is happening. What is the device trying to measure? Why is it measuring it like that?
That's working perfect.
Oh, that's good. All right, shut it down, we're done. This is a one of our critical care devices. So this is an anesthesia machine. This involves two disciplines, essentially. So there's a biomechanical division, which essentially handles all the gas exchanges, and the monitoring side, which involves all the real-time waveform monitoring while the patient is anesthetised.
I have an opportunity now to look at the gas side of this, which is the ventilator here. And we've also got two anaesthetic agent delivery units there.
These are all modular devices. What we'll do is we'll just take a module out. This module, when it's hooked into this rack, will actually measure all your vital signs. So it'll measure your ECG, non-invasive blood pressure, your oxygen saturation, temperature, and invasive blood pressures. And we can check all those with our simulators, making sure the correct measurements are coming up, making sure they're accurate.
Module. And this is our tester.
Engineers are dedicated to certain areas of the hospital. So there'll be an engineer in ICU, one in theatres, one in emergency, one in cardiovascular medicine on a yearly rotation basis. If you're particularly a person that's good on an IT or computer level, you could look after the medical ICT component. For instance, central stations. A lot of the medical devices now are using standard operating systems to monitor patients. Someone who's really got a good frontline skill to repairing devices to a board or a component level. So they would be a good bench engineer. Another person could have a good personality but has enough understanding of the electronics. So they would be sent out as a field engineer, for instance, to deal with the nurses, the clinicians. As far as central stations goes and patient monitoring, that's where the IT component is. So if something happens to it, if it crashes or glitches for whatever reason, to understand the computer basics behind it, how to resolve that. Doesn't need, you know, your standard restart. Has a hardware failed on the computer? Was it just a glitch where a reboot is more than enough? Patient monitors in the high criticality wards are then monitored via a central computer, which for the most part looks like a standard computer, but essentially it's a medical device because it's relaying patient information. So it's actually very critical. So for instance, your coronary care wards, where one nurse could be looking after four bed areas, it's easier to monitor them via a central location. I think I was pretty good at a people person level. I had good interactions with all clinical staff. So now what I do at a senior engineer level, an administrative level, is that now I will supervise some of the guys out there, plus also be involved with actually equipment that's purchased by the hospital. So I will sit on tender panels, evaluation committees. I do get to work on equipment occasionally, not as often, you know, as I used to, but I do still get hands-on. you know, it's not a boring job. It's actually a very exciting job.